So good morning to all. Here we are going to discuss about this semester industrial automation course. So now we are going to elaborate what are the major units we are going to cover in our industrial automation course, and the course designer and the in charge will be. And now we move on to our unit 1. So in industrial automation, it is broadly classified into major categories as fluid power automation, and another one is PLC based automation. And in fluid power, we are detailing about pneumatics, hydraulics, proportional type of pneumatic and hydraulic, and how the electrical parameter enter into our pneumatic and hydraulic to make electro pneumatic and electro hydraulic. Further in detail, we are going to have major component discussions as directional control valve, which is part of our control system, and we discussed about how the directional control valves are classified, and we are having a construction of a direction control valve. Either it will be a spool type or it may be a different type of construction, and then we are discussing about other valves like pressure control valves, flow control valves, and after that we are discussing about actuators. Either it will be a linear type actuator or rotatory type actuator, and the last we detailing about different types of compressors and pump width motors and their filter regulator and lubrication circuit. So the unit 1 broadly discussed about the architecture and components of your fluid power automation, and in unit 2 we are discussing about the circuit designing. For example, we have some industrial problems. In particular industrial problems like stamping operations or drilling hole in a given job operations, for that we are following major operation systems like sequential and cascading, and how our pneumatic and hydraulic system performs these sequential operation and cascading operation. For doing so, we took some industrial problems, and for that industrial problem we are performing some hands-on demo. Since it is an online class, so we will have a remote demo, and we may have some virtual demonstration using FluidSim software and using Automation Studio and PLC along with a simulation software. So here the broader area to be covered will be pneumatic, electro-pneumatic, hydraulic and electro-hydraulic circuits. So later in our unit 3, we directly enter into our PLC basics. So what do you mean by programmable logic controller, and how the programmable logic controller play a vital role in Industry 4.0. So here in unit 3, we discuss about architecture of PLC, and after that we are detailing about major components like internal relays, how we can able to use make contact and break contact, and the major performance like timer and counter operations. Once we understand all this, we directly go with some functional block diagram operations and ladder logic operations. So further it is detailing into different types of timers. So in our syllabus we cover turn off T off timer and turn on T on timer, and a redundant timer also we are using. And in counter we are having increment and decrement counters like up counter and down counter, and by using these timers and counter how we can able to program in real time PLCs. We will have an hands-on as well as we will have a remote access for our industrial automation lab using Infrasoft PLC in Bosch workshop. And once we cover the basic PLC programs, now we move on to the unit 4, where we will have a crisp definitions about how the human machine interface play a vital role in Industry 4.0, and how the SCADA logic operations can be used to supervise and monitor the systems present in some remote areas. Like that we can be able to do. So in this unit, we are detailing about what do you mean by HMI and what do you mean by SCADA, and in that the remote terminal unit, how we can be able to use SCADA in which application we are performing. For that, how the RTU, remote terminal unit, do the operations, and with the help of RTO, how we can be able to do the master slave operations. That concepts are discussed in our unit 4, and we will do some demonstration using SCADA and HMI in our PLC program. And along with that, we will have some communication protocols like the subtopic futures pro. The communication protocols like Profibus, Circas, OPC, UEA, we will discuss in our unit 4. With the help of these communication protocols, how we can be able to communicate our actuators or controllers with respect to our PLC programming systems. So in remote, we will have motor in one end and we will have a controller in another end. How we can be able to communicate the controller with motor by using these types of communication protocol. These things are explained in our unit. And the ladder logic, since we are having all PLCs from Bosch structure and from Siemens and also from Fisto, so with the help of PicoSoft, we will do the ladder logic programming and functional block diagrams. And schematic softwares we are having, so with the help of that also we will do the Siemens IoT kind of PLC programming. And IndraWorks software we will use to perform the SCADA virtual explanation, that is by using block diagrams, how we can be able to visually control as like your lab view concepts. And in last unit, we are going to implement all the ideas which you grasp from unit 1 to unit 4, and we are going to apply in our application. So we will have some broader applications in PLC Industry 4.0 problems, and we will take AC and DC servo drive problems, and we will take mobile hydraulic problems and pneumatic problems also. For that, with the help of your understanding, we are going to give some solutions for simulation problems like process automation. Either it may be an industry process automation or robot process automation, how the PLC can be used to control the actuators present inside the system. And for that, we will do some simulation as a demonstration, and even the assignments will be given as a mini project assignment to integrate a pneumatic hydraulic for your industrial application. So these are all the things we will cover in unit 5 with real-time industrial problem. So by this, our overview of our industrial automation schedule is completed, and soon we will meet you in real topics in unit 1 to unit 5.